What is up, you guys? It's RJ. Welcome back to my channel. For some reason, I can't figure out the last song that I like listened to from NCTU. I feel like it's been a while for some reason. Actually, I think it might have been Baby Don't Stop and The Seventh Sense. That seems like ages ago. I don't know why, but like, yeah, it just seems like I watched that like months ago or something like that. But either way, we're back with NCTU to check out Work It. This is a song that doesn't have all of, well, actually, that's not true because NCTU is a revolving unit, so I feel like I expected to see the same amount of members that NCT127 has, but there's only 6 people in this song, I believe. So I wonder who's gonna be in it. Yeah, let's go ahead and get right into the song. All right, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Oh, I got my water bottle here because I don't know what to expect from these guys. What? Who was the blonde? What the heck was that? Is Johnny? Oh my god, what? Wait, I gotta see this more. Oh, Jamin. Wait. Things are happening too fast. Henry. Wow. Jisung. Wow. Oh, Jungwoo. Yo, Johnny looks good with that hair. Utah. Alright, y'all, don't be mad at me. I'm gonna start this over. If you wanna skip to the part that I stopped it at, but I that's fine. I couldn't pay attention to the song because I was too busy trying to figure out who was in the song at first. So now that I've got it, it's Jamin, Jisung, Utah, Mark, Ten, and Johnny. Interesting combination. This is a look on Johnny, for real. Also, Jamin is freaking gorgeous. Oh, Henry, wait. I'm so confused now. Okay, I was just missing Henry. And Jungwoo, what the heck is going on? I don't know anything anymore. You know what's crazy? Jamin really, he can pull off like any hair color. Like the first time I think I saw him was in Make-A-Wish. He had white hair there and he looked stunning in that. And then I just recently saw him in Raiden in NCT Dream and he had blue hair there. And I had to pause on him for a moment because he just like, he looked beautiful with that hair. And here he is now with black hair, and he still, like, looks like a freaking prince. Wait, Mark is not in this song. Am I crazy? Ten is beautiful. Hendry. Yeah. I appreciate that this is Johnny's real hair because he looks so good. I mean, I wasn't like crazy about the wig and wakey wakey. I didn't hate it either. Jungwoo's getting it. Okay, I don't know what that was, but I'm gonna replay this because I was hella confused, clearly, and I don't know what, I don't know why I thought I heard Mark in this song. Clearly he's not there. I don't know who else I said that I thought was in this song that is not there, but yeah, okay. I really liked a few things in this song, specifically the bridge and how in the very last part of the song, they combined the sound from the bridge and the sound from the chorus originally. It sounded so good. It sounded really, 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 really good. Okay. That line threw me. Utah. This is an interesting chorus. Like, this beat is bizarre. But I like it. Also, the suits look really good on all of them. You know, Johnny has really been coming for me lately, especially after that sticker teaser. Seriously, Johnny looks real good with that hair. And I knew they were gonna pull this R&B type bridge with the way that the song was. It was very like one note-ish in a way. I just knew the bridge was gonna feel like this. Stunning. They look so good in those suits. I love this part with Tongue Room. I like the way this ends out. Nice. What is this? That looks like all of them, like every single one of the members. Definitely enjoyed that the second time around for sure. When I was able to actually just kind of process the whole song together and not just pieces of it. I loved the, like, you know, like the way they combined the different like sounds in the song was really clever by the end of the song. Because like I said, like when they, I knew for like, I just knew the bridge was gonna sound very, I don't know, not the same, because the song was very kind of had the same, I don't know how to describe it, but it sounded similar from the verse to the pre-chorus to the chorus and then on. And then you get to the bridge and it's very like, you know, smooth and melodic in a way. And I was like, oh, this sounds great. And I was hoping they were gonna do something like that, and they did. And then they went and combined the both of them together at the end. And that was just really smart. Jungwoo really was really cute in that part where he was just kind of like. Anyways, let's go ahead and get on to the dance practice next. All right, 3, 2, 1, let's go. I like watching Ten dance a lot. I wonder what made them choose this combination of, like, I wonder how that works. Because this isn't a group that I guess you would expect to be in a song together. I don't know, I guess you just kind of always expect the usual suspects, like one of the main vocalists or one of the main rappers. But I guess you've got Jamin there. And Jisung is rapper too. And then Jungwoo is, you know, Jungwoo's a vocalist, but I don't feel like he's like given enough shine. And I guess this is probably why he's in here then. Johnny too. Oh, I thought they were just vibing out. I saw that too. Jamin caught that. He was like, oh, you're trying to. See, Jungwoo is just too cute. Jungwoo. He's cute until he's like wearing crop tops in your face. So I noticed they had 2 from Dream, 2 from 127, and 2 from Wavy to make this particular song. So I guess I'm always just curious like how, like what makes them come up with that particular combination, and like what makes them choose the particular people from the units to go into NCTU for a particular song. I'm assuming it's probably, you know, which I guess can be explained as well, why some members get more lines than others in songs. Maybe their voice just doesn't fit that particular concept the best than the others. And that was probably the case for this particular song, the way that the song was constructed. They probably felt that these members suited the song the best. probably answer my own question that I was asking earlier, but that's my guess. I don't know if it's legit, but I'm gonna go with that one. The song kind of gave me Super M's We Do vibes, even though I think this came out before We Do. But in that, like, I don't know, there's a bit of a groove in that R&B bridge that just kind of took me to We Do, and I liked it a lot. All right, thanks so much for hanging out with me today, you guys. If you liked the video, leave a like and a comment and subscribe. Maybe hit the notification bell if that's your thing, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later.